Hey guys, how you going? Metal here. Today I'm going to show you how you can create that sticker effect that I use on a lot of my thumbnails in Gimp. Now Gimp is a free program much like Photoshop, and I'm going to put the link to that download down in the description below for you. I'll try to keep this quick, so let's get into it. Okay, what I'm going to do is I'm actually going to create the sticker effect that I use for this thumbnail for the video. Once you've loaded your image into Gimp, what you need to do is go to this icon here, which is the paths tool. So I'm going to start selecting my image now. I'm going to start about here. I don't want to start at the bottom of my image, and I'm going to start using the paths tool to select around my image. Now I'm going to go on the inside of my fingers here, not the outside, because I'm a little bit worried about that pink and purple backlight getting into my image, because that'll kind of ruin the sticker effect a little bit. Now I don't need to be too specific here, but if I want to later on, I'll show you how you can change up your image a little bit if you want to be a bit more specific in your selection. Once you go around your image, you can click enter, and that's going to confirm your selection and give you this crawling ants effect. Now, what you might want to do is change some of your selections a little bit. So I can see that maybe on my finger or my thumb here, I might want to make a couple of selections. I might want to drag these out a little bit just by clicking and dragging. What I can also do is hold control, and I can see where my shoulder is here. I've cut a little bit of it off. So if I hold control, I can click and drag that line to be a bit more curved now, and I might do that here as well, just to curve it in a little bit. Now what I want to do is I want to invert my selection, so I go select and I go invert, and that now selects the background of the image. Now what I want to do is I want to make the background transparent, so I go into layer, transparency, add alpha channel, then I want to go back into layer, back into transparency, and this time color to alpha. Now my transparency threshold is currently set to 0. If I click and hold all the way to the end, it changes to 1.0, and you can see that I've got my background transparent now. So I can click OK and get rid of that, and I want to change my selection back to my image now, so I can go select, invert, back to where we were. Now, if I go to the right-hand side, what I need to do is to create a new layer, but I want to make sure that my new layer is behind my top layer, which is my image, because what we're going to do now is create that sticker effect. Now I'm going to go into select, and what I'm going to do is I'm going to grow my selection. So I think at about 12 would be fine, but depending on how big or small your image is, you might want to play around with that a little bit for your desired effect. After you've done that, you can see that my crawling ants has increased in size. It's gone around my image now. After I do that, I want to go into edit and fill with background color, and that's going to fill the background with white. Now I can see that I've still got a little bit of purple backlight sneaking in here, so I'm going to get rid of that. So what I'm going to do is click the paintbrush icon, and then what I'm going to do is to make sure I've got my current picture layer selected, and I'm going to zoom in, and what I'm going to do is I'm just going to color this in white here, just a little smooth color to get rid of that. There we go, that looks pretty good now. After that, we need to save this. So I'm going to go File, Export As, and you have to make sure that you save it as a PNG image. So now I'll export, and it's done. I hope this video was helpful. If it was, give it a thumbs up and subscribe to the channel if you haven't before, and turn on that bell.